Hey guys, Standing Simmer here today, and welcome back to the channel for another apartment renovation here in The Sims 4. Now guys, just a little full disclosure here at the beginning, a little confession on my part. This is the second time I've tried to record this voiceover, and the first attempt lasted about 5 seconds, and that's because I couldn't remember what I was doing, even though I'm looking at the footage right here in front of me. So it was kind of a train wreck, like right from the beginning. But anyways, guys, we are doing an apartment renovation, despite the fact that I just totally blanked a second ago when I tried to record this the first time, but we are renovating an apartment over in the Culpeper House District. Fun fact, guys, it is one of my favorite apartment districts in San Myshuno. I love these apartments a lot. Main reason is that they look very genuine to what some like regular apartments would look like. I'm not, of course, speaking from experience though, so don't like come at me if that's not correct, but I've never personally lived in an apartment, but what I imagine a typical like couple or family dwellings to be in like your low to mid-range apartment districts, like this is kind of what I think about. So they just seem very realistic to me, and that's why I like these apartments so much. But anyways, guys, this is in Culpeper House. I want to say it's like 19, but it's on the top left-hand corner of the screen, and it's bigger for you guys as you're watching it right now than what it is for me. So if you want to look at that more closely, it's there. I also try to put those in the my gallery descriptions too. There's like almost nothing more frustrating. I mean, there are things more frustrating, but it's frustrating when you go to download an apartment off the gallery and you have absolutely no idea where it's placed. Like, you love the apartment and you want to play in it, but you don't know where it's supposed to go. So I try to put those things in my descriptions on the gallery. And just speaking of the gallery, like while we're here, let's just go ahead and segue right into the fact that this is on the gallery. So if you guys do want to download it, it's there under my user, which is Standing Simmer. And I also put this under the hashtag Standing Simmer, as I typically do with my builds. If I remember and can do so, I will put a link in the description, which I've been somewhat good about doing here recently. It kind of honestly depends more on if the gallery is behaving or not. If I can't get a hold of the link on my web browser, then I won't be able to put it in the description. But, you know, fingers crossed and all that good stuff. So guys, the whole point behind this apartment, and I think that I'm going to call it Pops of Orange or something like that, but the long story short is that it's for my Orange Generation Sim for Not So Berry. So I recently just, actually this last weekend, rounded off the Plum Generation in a current household update. I actually like shared that final event with you guys in the form of that update. So if you guys haven't seen that yet, then I highly recommend you go check it out. It went up on Saturday. If I remember, I'll link that as well in the description, but we'll see if that happens. Typically when I'm putting together these descriptions, when I'm uploading the video, I'm doing so very late at night, the night before the videos go up, and I don't always remember like what I say I'm going to, you know, put in the description. I don't always remember to get it there, you know, it's a whole thing. But guys, rounded off the Plum Generation, I'm full on to Orange now in my personal gameplay. You guys will get to see a little bit more of kind of the mess that that's already started to become in this upcoming week's current household update. But of course, my Orange Generation Sim needed a place to live, so I've really been having a good time here recently with letting my builds be completely purposeful and intentional, in that they're typically for things that I need in my personal gameplay. Right now I'm playing so many saves and so many challenges of my own that I do actually have quite a need for houses if I want to play in my own houses, or my own apartments in this case. So I really have been enjoying having that intention behind the builds that I've been putting out here recently, mainly because I have no other inspiration. Like, my inspiration right now is like at nothing at the moment, and the main reason for that is, I've spoken about this before, but we have so much new content that's like coming at us in a couple of weeks' time by the time that this video is going out, that I just don't know what I want to build right now. And so if I'm going to be putting something together, it's right now, it's really been more for my personal households. So this is no exception. I am creating this for that sim, my Orange Gen Sim. So it is for a Not So Berry Sim. I definitely created it with my Orange Gen Sim in mind. If you guys know anything about the Not So Berry Challenge, you'll know that the rules kind of state right from the beginning that the Orange Generation Sim has to live in a needs TLC apartment for all of his or her young adult life. And this is, of course, one of those apartments. So a needs TLC apartment, in case you don't know, is one that requires a lot of work. While you're in the apartment, you get things like leaky pipes, you get smells that are just emitted from the floor for no reason whatsoever. You get mice and rats and cockroaches and just grodiness that is just everywhere when you're living in these apartments. And they're kind of a pain to live in for that reason. Typically your Sims are tense like all the time when they're living here, because if it's not one issue, it's another, and you have to try to repair it, or you complain to the landlord to try to get it fixed. And it's just a mess. So like literally and figuratively, it's a mess. So these Need CLC apartments are kind of meant to represent like the starter of the starter apartments, because you're in it because you might not be able to afford something different or something just a hair better without these kind of crazy prevalent issues. So the Orange Generation Sim is like meant to start off in the criminal career. They like to bake. So I really wanted to put in like a really nice kitchen. And I also put in a computer so that you can load up your mischief skill, which is really important for starting off in the criminal career. And then of course, like a mirror anywhere can kind of get you started with the charisma skill, which is another thing that you need for Orange Gen of Not So Berry. Now, again, if you guys know anything about Not So Berry, you'll know that Orangen is, of course, supposed to have kids. This is not the end of the legacy. So the Pink Generation comes following Orange Generation, and Orangen Sim has to have two children only, and they have to be twins. So I did not put a bedroom for those children in this apartment. However, I'll tell you what I did for my personal gameplay, which of course I am already to that point in my personal gameplay. It's a little spoiler to what you might be seeing in the update later this week, but I went ahead and turned what I made into the dining room into a bedroom for the kiddos. So in this apartment, there's an archway that separates the living room from the dining room. And I actually really like the dining room a lot. However, when it came time to the Sim having kids, we needed a place to put them, and that could very, very easily function as a second bedroom. So just let you guys know what I did with that room and how you could accommodate children in this apartment, whether or not you're playing with Not So Berry. I mean, obviously this does not just have to be a Not So Berry apartment. However, I do recommend that the Sims who live here would probably initially like the color orange. I mean, that kind of makes sense, unless of course you change the color scheme entirely. I was actually building this while I was talking on Discord with some friends. That is actually just such an enjoyable thing, by the way. If you have Discord and you are somewhat comfortable with some of the people that you know in there, if you have friends in a Discord server, just try out a voice chat channel. Like, it is so much fun to be able to talk to people while you're doing other things. I actually put this together almost exactly a week ago when I'm recording this, and I told you that I was doing it while talking to friends, because if there are really weird pauses here and there that I may have neglected to edit out, then that's definitely why. I was taking my time, like, and I would stop for a second and do something else, and I'd be chatting and I'd kind of get distracted. So it is a lot of fun though to talk to people while you're doing these sort of things. I've heard people say that before, and I never really had the opportunity prior to meeting this group of friends that I have now. And there are a couple particular people that are just really close to my heart that I chat with on a very, very regular basis. And it's just fun to do that when you have, it's just fun to do things like this, I guess, when you have people to talk to, because it makes the whole process go by a lot more quickly. In fact, the night that I put this together, I didn't actually intend to do so. I was really more just scoping out the Needs TLC apartments in San Myshuno, because there are three, I think. Don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure that that's correct. I believe that there are three total in all of San Myshuno. And I chose this one because it is a little bit bigger and it allows you to really kind of have a family in it temporarily, because you can't move out of it, like I said earlier, until you're an adult. So I wanted to make sure that we had some room to grow, and I didn't exactly go out of my way to make the furniture really crappy. Like, I didn't necessarily want it to look really, really gross or anything like that, but you know, you still have all those problem areas that are probably gonna make your Sims lives miserable while they live here. But guys, we are already rounding off the video, and I just want to say thank you so much for tuning in today for this apartment renovation for The Sims 4. Guys, stay tuned later in the week for a larger build that I'm excited to bring to you guys. But like I said, gonna go ahead and round things off right there. So thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. I hope you're having the best of days, and I will see you very soon. Bye.